Baby, me and G. Tell me, how can I survive? Remember me? Life is a G's, money making activities. It's killing me, I'm trying to ball.
What's up, guys? Today I'm checking out this 1995 hip hop documentary, The Show. Haven't heard it before. Well, I haven't seen it before, thinking this is a song. But now that I think about it, The Show, isn't that like the soundtrack where like all those songs came from? Like, you know, like Bone Thugs and Harmony's Everyday Thing. Like, it was a sound part of the soundtrack for The Show. And I think this is like The Show. And like a whole bunch of other songs came from the soundtrack for this, so I'm wondering if this is like, I feel like it was, but pretty interesting to know. But I haven't seen it yet. Pretty interested to check it out. But without further ado, let's go and get into this hip hop documentary. Hopefully it's real good too, because I've been like looking for a good hip hop documentary, one like I can check out. But yeah, let's go. Oh my goodness, bro. It is super cold too. Like, the weather is just so...
G! Hold up, man.
Hey, yo, I like it up here.
I want to see Philly represent when this shit drop.
Hey, yo, G! I like it up here.
I love it up here, man.
This is, Lady, yeah,
I mean, you say, I want to hear a new flavor.
This is amazing, bro.
At this time, we want to receive with a rousing round of applause our beloved captain here, Muhammad's Mosque number 12 in Philadelphia, Brother Captain Gregory Tuat.
Rap music.
Fuck what people got to say. I don't give a fuck.
Hip hop is writing and rhyming.
This is hip hop music, and this is all we got.
A way of life. To hold the mic in your hand and crush whoever's in front of you. That's hip hop.
You'll be gonna get in. You'll be running back and please. Come on.
Like,
wait a stop, sir.
Keep it down. You have no need to think that your instructions have already been thought out.
If a nigga gonna get me, a nigga gonna get me. Ain't like I can't be got. It's just gonna be hard as fuck.
If you don't have the proper identification, you will not be permitted to come in. Lock it down.
I'm not leaving the ghetto shit. He said, that's fly. Kids want to hear that.
Brothers, people with tickets have no special privilege.
You don't even know what we're going to do next. We got so many hits.
And it was actually a piece of paper that's saying that, saying he gave away his hits for a watch and a motherfucking chain.
And just like a piece of Vaseline, if it inside my stomach, with the exit grips between.
Never had nothing to believe before they had records. They talked all that shit and then they did it.
When money get involved in this shit, that's when niggas start making mistakes.
The ones who did it and didn't talk shit, they don't want to do it.
That you did personally use a firearm.
Here comes the brand new flavor,
If I was not in the studio and not doing this shit right now and in this motherfucking trailer, you know what I'm saying, and doing this positive shit, I'd probably be right in your motherfucking house right now, tying your ass up in your fucking safe, slapping your kids around on the real.
Brand new flavor! Flavor, yeah! Come on!
So all the wannabes tonight could have been, has been, gonna go in the bin.
Brand new flavor!
Assalamu
alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Bro, this looks amazing. Yo. So this is like a movie or a TV series? No, this is probably like the show. Poetic Justice music? Is it? I'm waiting for that. Da-na-na-na-na. Oh yeah, this is definitely it. Oh man, that's like a good 90s film, bro.
Oh, I've been to Rikers before, yeah. Yeah, but I ain't, you know, I ain't one of them niggas that like Rikers to visit out. People. They fucked up when they in jail. I got to hear them. They call collect on the phone, but I'm not coming. I'm sending you commissary, but I'm not coming.
Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow.
I don't want to come visit no rappers in jail. I'm saying, for what? It sold a million too. I wish, you know, I mean, it's supposed to be, I mean, I'm not no role model or nothing. I'm not trying to be, you know, but I don't think, you know, if you got all that success, you can't, you know, and I want, you know, I always tell artists, you know, it's all right to be, you know, to be real. Real is, you know, everybody say, I wish I got to where you got. If I got to where you got, I would not be throwing no guns in nobody's faces or robbing nobody or none of that. Or just being in, somebody got to be for me, believe me, they could go. I'm only going to see Ricky because of the movie. I'm saying that's the only reason. You gotta cut it out? Well, you should make it real. Come on, and you know, I don't understand. I'm older though, I'm 37 years old. I wanna travel around the world and chase famous models. I'm still always gonna be ghetto. I'm too old not to be.
Chase famous
models. I'm saying I'm who I am, but I ain't gotta do, you know what I'm saying? I'm not broke, so I ain't gotta throw no guns in nobody's faces for nothing. I don't even wanna see no guns if I can help it. I got a Rolls Royce. I don't feel like hurting nobody. I don't want nobody near me with no type of drama. Only drama I want is Naomi Campbell. I'm not fucking with Ricky. I don't even know what he's gonna talk about. That nigga called me four times. I missed each call. I don't know what he's gonna. He wants his jewelry. I know that much. That's kind of fly, you know. That's his ego talking. That's why his records is so dope. He'll tell you in a minute. All of them is crumbs, and they all want to be me.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. And you peasant poor pieces of trash.
Bro, this is good so far.
Ego talking. You know, that's the type of shit he would say on his records. They all want to be him, the ruler. And he used to play that shit, the ruler.
The name is Slick Rick, the ruler, the rich ruler, by the way.
Oh, man, have you seen the pictures of him with the king hat on and the jewelry? He was as crazy as a bag of angel dust. I mean, personally, crazy.
What's up, Daddy?
How you make it out in here, kid?
Appreciate your freedom a lot more, you know? The little things. You know, you don't be so materialistic afterwards. Stuff like that, you know? Appreciate family, life, all that good stuff, you know? So when the album's supposed to drop? November the what?
November 22nd, I think.
November 22nd?
That's perfect for that Christmas money. It's gonna be good.
A lot of the music, as good as we think it is, or Warren G did a good job, it ain't 100% you, and people are waiting for your music. So when you come home, you know, we just, you know, see what you do on your own. I know you feel like it could be better.
Hey, I don't got nothing against no producers. I mean, everybody got their props or they wouldn't be producers. You know what I'm saying? It's just that this man can't be me and I can't be him. You know what I'm saying? He might make good music like Warren G and Snoop. They got their own style. You know what I'm saying? And Pete Rock or then this one and that one, they got their style. And their shit sells when they work together with.
Okay.
But if you put this with this, sometimes it just don't mix, you know what I'm saying?
We can't understand how these kids get these opportunities. Like, you know, they got this gift, they make these records, they get success. And instead of taking that success and doing the right thing, a lot of them take that success and as a green light to go to hell, to do all the wrong shit. And that, to me, is a shock. But I keep seeing it more and more. Not to name any artists, but a lot of artists, even the ones that aren't in the news because of it, they got with their hit record comes a lot of drama that they don't need.
The country, the world is bugging out as it is, you know? Brothers are just talking all type of mad stuff. I guess that's the way they feel like expressing themselves. But then when they have their shows and stuff, they got to live up to that image because they drawing a crowd that's on some rah-rah.
Yo, check it out, straight from Brooklyn, mm-hmm. Represent. Check it out. Who the fuck is this? the morning, crack of dawn, now I'm yawning. Wipe the cold out my eyes. See who's this paging me and why? It's my nigga Pop from the barbershop. Told me he was in the game with spot. Heard the intricate plot. Niggas wanna stick me like a fly. Slow down, love. Drop the paper.
Remember them niggas from the hill up and round hill? That you roll dice with, smoke blunts and got nice with.
Yeah, my nigga Fame up the roster. Nah, them my niggas, nah, love wouldn't disrespect.
Check, I didn't say Bill. They schooled me to some niggas that you knew from back when. When you were clocking minor figures. Now that hood you're blowing up like nitro. When they wanna stick the knife through your windpipe slow. So they Fame for warning me, cause now I'm warning you. I got the map, nigga, tell me what you wanna do.
Damn, niggas wanna stick me for my paper. Damn, niggas wanna stick me for my paper. Damn, niggas wanna stick me.
I'm the nigga in traffic. Because I know how niggas is. When you're in the streets and you hustling, you know how niggas is because you was one of them niggas. You know what I'm saying? You on the corner, you trying to get your money. You see a nigga rolling by in a Benz or a Beamer. You know what I'm saying? You're like, fuck that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Fuck, I stopped. I murdered that nigga. I robbed that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Now, yeah. I'm the nigga in the Benz or the Beamer. You know what I'm saying? Driving past other corners. So I know the same speech is coming out. You know what I'm saying? But it's all good, though. I ain't tripping. I'm that nigga.
Prior to 13 years of age, he was just a son. A son that any mother would like. Mm. At 13, he became notorious.
Uh-huh. And then when I started doing the music and I started like slipping shit out the music and shit, she was like, I didn't know Christopher did this and I didn't know he did that. She would always come in and see the drugs and shit. And I'd be like, it's Chico's. You know what I'm saying? My mom used to do some wild shit, man. Throw my work in the toilet. She used to put knives to Chico neck. Shit like that. That's horrible. Just bugging, like. But it's like, it was nothing she could do to stop a nigga. Like, I tell her I'm gonna stop. I ain't gonna fuck around no more. She'll kick me out the crib. But I just, like, come back in, tell her I ain't doing it, and still be doing it. Ready to Die was 95% the chronic, 5% of me. All the rest of that shit was the weed, man. All that suicidal thought shit, all that little extra shit that niggas ain't really supposed to be talking about, that was the weed talking, man. Blame that on a lot.
It's censored on the radio. You don't hear, I think, what he's really saying.
I wasn't really looking at it as like, well, how am I feeling right now? Well, I feel like killing myself. I'm gonna write a rhyme about it. It wasn't like that. I was just thinking like, damn, I remember when I used to be stressed out in the same fucking room. You know what I'm saying? And like, it was to the point where I was like, I want to kill myself. I was just like, damn, my baby mom's stressing me. My mom's stressing me. You know what I'm saying? Niggas ain't fuck with me. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no money. I'm broke. The av is hot and they can't get no money. A nigga just be like, yo, fuck, if I was dead, I wouldn't have to worry about nothing. I could just lay up. Either I'd be in heaven or hell. I'd just be laying the fuck up, just chilling. I wouldn't have to worry about no problems. That's what I was on. I wasn't on no killing myself shit. I was just saying if I was dead, I'd be a lot better off. And sometimes I still be feeling like that. See, all these fucking motherfuckers want to stress a nigga out over some bullshit, some rap shit. It's supposed to be fun.
We introduce everybody. That's everybody you know.
This is Warren G, you know what I'm saying?
Has it gone platinum yet, Johnny? It's platinum now.
Almost double.
Double.
It'll be double by the end of next week.
Explain to them what double means, platinum.
2 million records, you know, CDs, tapes.
Okay.
So.
Hey, Warren G. Hey, Warren G.
What?
You gotta hurry up, Coolie already on.
I just want to be able to talk to somebody tonight. Once you get off schedule when you're doing one of these tours that are long distance tour dates over 500 miles per day, you got to be rolling. You got to be almost rolling
miles
like an express. If you get off schedule, it's
I mean,
all,
they
it's all
like
fucked
some
up.
Buzz,
I got 5 o'clock in Black Press wants to see him in the lobby. All right, Black, that's important. We never see him.
So I ain't gonna get to do nothing, huh?
That'd be quick.
This happened in every city, every, and then I
no,
leave.
No, this doesn't happen every city.
5 foot is in the house. This is a 5 foot session. Neb is in the house, motherfucker. I'm not stressing. At my best and on the microphone, it's me, the N.E.B. Feeling Irie. When I hit the split, I got the gift to uplift any nigga or negro with the fro in the back. Yo, pass the flow to my homegirl, Josh Skills. Beatboxing, cause we're on the real.
So what's up with the 5 foot?
They have flow, bro. That
we can work this
right
out,
there.
But what they don't like, so I guess I'm gonna send in conditions.
Man, this is good. This is golden wrestling right here. This is some golden.
Yeah, I ain't paying for this shit.
Come on, Warren. Every group has the hairdresser.
I ain't paying for no motherfucking hairdresser. If they want that shit, but be my guest.
Sorry, I think
I'm supposed to just say fuck them and change the motherfucker.
We're braided.
They got braids in their hair, so what? I mean, what's that?
This is called ghetto burning. When you burn your hair, when it starts frizzing.
They got braids in their hair, but they need a hairdresser. What else he say, Uncle Ronnie?
Basically, wish he would firm up a little early in the game than waiting until he has to blow up. He makes his own decisions.
Conditions, this. They act like I'm getting paid $60,000 or something. I'm just saying, all this trying to be business, talking about conditions, and this is the conditions we...
Conditions for what?
If y'all gonna come, y'all gonna have to let us know something. We gotta know today for sure.
They still have a production contract with Warren.
I don't.
You let him out of the contract?
Yeah. If they really wanna get out.
Well, let's ask them again.
I ain't about holding nobody. That's what it is about me.
We work the situation
If I ain't gonna work with you, what's the use of me holding you?
I'll let you go.
It ain't no thing to me, because you're not making me or breaking me. The music industry breaks. If when you come in as friends, it breaks you up. It breaks you up.
That's true.
Got them five swingers in their pocket.
It ain't them. It's their manager.
Well, he twisting their ass up. He about to fuck them up.
You just tell us what you want, and let's get on with this tour. And incidentally, Gil, you're not holding the tour up, because we did our first night last night.
And blew it
and
up.
And it was the shit.
That's Ron G at his best, baby. At his best. That's why my business is taken care of so swell.
All right, y'all. Ready to go?
Throw your hands in the motherfucking air and wave the motherfuckers like you just don't care.
If you puff on the weed, then y'all do that shit. I do that shit, oh, I do that shit. And if your ass got a buzz, then y'all drink that shit. I drink that shit, oh, I drink that shit. When it's the duper, the duper, the Land Cruiser trooper. Tic Tacs that time to hang up my mind like Mr. Cooper. I'm taking you to a zone that was born for whackness. So please get your down.
Butter, could you hack this?
Yo, oh no, grab a hold of Vatables. Getting her flows on like JoJo runs in a marathon. So much smooth like jumping to warm me. Big mama daddy. Feels like another one's going out my whole brain. Step back, because I happen to be on that plus tax. Got more subscribers than HBO Hearts in the mat. Mal after mal.
I rip style after style.
Cracked open all the bags.
I can't avoid it. You know what I'm saying? I got homies that gang bang, got uncles that bang. I'm gang related. Even if I don't gang bang, my mama live in a gang related neighborhood. So when I go through that hood, I'm gonna say, "What's happening, cuz?" And I'm treated as a gang member. So I'm gang related.
He doesn't have to come from the East Coast or the West Coast. So that means, on that note, put your hands together for my peoples, Snoop Dogg and the Dogg Pound.
Put your motherfucking hands in the air. And you don't motherfuckers. Make some motherfucking noise. We won. And then we shot that BB gun. And they lost. Now we took that shit. Now I even step. Motherfuckers hit the deck. I get wrecked with a check. So passing like check. Yeah. I got my own back in the crap.
Yo, this song is nice. I'm gonna skip this one and find out what song that is. That sounds good.
Little Johnny, you can
You could be a lawyer or a basketball player. That's going to make you want to do that. You know what I'm saying? It's only the truth. And we just tell the kids and shit, as far as our music is concerned, from what we grew up, is that you could be whatever you want to be. But the life that we had to live was out there. It was rough. It was hustling. It was gangbanging. It, okay, it was out there. And it ain't nothing we could do to change it. But that's how we lived. And we trying to figure out how can we change it by expressing it, letting y'all know that we done did it already. So, I mean, save yourself and don't go.
Why is this dude humping?
It's cool, you know what I'm saying, man? I mean, I'm sure everybody's upset about it. It's like everybody wants to say, yo, we've seen it, we lived it, and we ain't having it. That's what all the rappers is really saying, you know? They try to represent their neighborhoods, whatever. But we all seen it, we all lived it, and we all ain't having it. And now we got to move on to something else, you know what I'm saying? Okay, everybody, everything gonna be next man, I carry a bazooka. Next man, I got a tank. You know, all that's cool, you know what I'm saying? Trying to diss nobody, but, you know, got to move on, you know what I'm saying? Because, shit. We front in front of our friend, our homeboys, but we still gotta go home to Mom Dukes, you know what I'm saying? We can't front around Mom Dukes 24-7. Yo, Mom, what up? You know what I'm saying? Put the stash away, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Everybody got respect for their parents, you know what I'm saying?
We gangsters. We gangsters, we all do the same type of shit. It's something about being a dog pound gangster, claiming DPG for life. That gangster shit, that shit that the bust ass niggas talk about doing, wanna do. Act like they can do, but no, they can't do it. You know what I'm saying? It's like this. We ain't preaching about doing no hellified ass shit. We just speaking the real straight from the heart. All the shit we talk about is real.
I mean, it's not like I got a problem with gangster rappers, because sometimes they're telling their life the way they, you know, it's all they see.
See, it's another, the other thing is...
And it's informative. It's helpful. But when other people come along and they just do it because they think that's their ticket...
Back on the street, straight, blue and gray, cause I represent like every day. Nigga, you can't tell me I don't see no less. When I can tell you all the homies that we got shot from at least about 5 years ago, when I was in junior high, going to Marshall. The homie used to come up to the school and block, and leave and have a bitch, fly the job. Then the one that made some of the past, this is the pizza I bought, we can whoop a nigga's ass.
Bro, this is some true, like, 90s. Man, this is golden, bro.
Dog pound, Daz and Corrupt, two wild ass motherfuckers, don't give a fuck about nothing. You know what I'm saying? They just want to make some records, make some money.
Yeah, I mean, that's our clique, you know what I'm saying? There's a distinction, you know? Like, when we say dog pound can mean all of our homies. But when we on record, we represent all of our homies, you know what I'm saying? This is the dog pound right here, gangsters. We the group, you know what I'm saying? Me and Dad.
The homies is putting it down.
Yeah, we the ones that put it down on the mic.
For the chemistry, they click. For it's him and Snoop, him and Daz, they all became like brothers. And they just, you know, join in and break each other, made some shit happen. Yep. For us, you know, I ain't with that Hollywood shit. I like these little niggas because they gangsters. You know what I'm saying? They ain't with all that punk shit. They don't care about trying to have their hair done a certain way. They ain't caring, like, you know what I'm saying? Trying to be all on cameras. They just put their shit down.
Yeah. Dr. Dre came and reinvented rap from a West Coast standpoint, and took that rock and roll energy that the East Coast had and took it somewhere way else. And then Suge Knight came along and got with Dre, and they went and got the money they're supposed to get, the position and the company. So they own the company and own their end of the business. And it's like everybody can look at them and be inspired, because it's just Suge Knight, just a street nigga with all that energy, that raw energy and street smarts, you know, and took those smarts and beat everybody at their own game. So I can't say much about Death Row Records, Dre and Suge Knight, except, you know, I'm on their dick.
Corrupt and Daz is the dog pound group rappers, you know what I'm saying? They stepping out on the front to maintain, to represent the whole clique as far as rap-wise. They voice, they're the voices out there, you know what I'm saying? They are soldiers out there on the front line representing, speaking the real for us. I'm Snoop Dogg, I represent, what I represent is the whole dog pound is one, but we all is one. It ain't no such sections as, okay, you niggas run like this, nigga, we all one, we all family, nigga just got different titles and different job duties, but we all have them.
What would you do if you could fuck with my crew?
You can get with the dog pound. Everybody wants to be your dog pound gangster.
Snoop Dogg, baby, TPG, I know why.
Your love is the one they
said. Black ass Snoop.
Them niggas straight said that I bit they shit in.
Yeah. Oh.
What's up, Big Sky? I see you all in the motherfucking
calendar,
cuz.
What's up,
cuz? Calendar tight. Yeah, I'm going tight. Like, 213 with y'all pictures in the smoke? Back.
I said, that's Nate Dogg. What the fuck?
Everybody in the dog pound got equal criticism, like, meaning from the youngest to the oldest. If the youngest was to say, dog, that shit ain't hitting, change that shit, he got that love to make a nigga change it. I'm just saying, as far as the respect of everybody in the dog pound, that's what we need to address. There ain't no such thing as a leader or, you know, nigga get all the praises. Nigga, we all individuals. We all treated as
so
men.
They run like a little,
you know what I'm saying? On that page with respect. Everybody get
like
that same
too?
Respect.
Dog pound, how do y'all bet?
DP, DP, DPG.
I oughta start dipping, sipping on that SD gets me to tripping. I don't slip, I bang.
That mad ass dog pound gang is a DPG thing. Come up from the SC. You wanna test me? Let's see if you'll survive 45 times. Like a hollow boy headed for your dome. Take a couple steps, turn around and it's on. You couldn't withstand the murderous mental. I subdue and then take two to your 10 grand. When I call, solo calls from what's written. Make us collapse and when the straps is spitting.
Look, this is all done.
1, 2, 3. See, it's sorta just for good.
But you can't, yeah. So don't even think about stepping in the motherfucking
You think you can rap? You come around here with all that bullshit thinking that Death Row, you know what I'm saying? Or they can't really woo. I serve them off the top. They get served.
Whatever, I'm not doing
like the West Coast, they tell a story that East Coast don't go through. You know what I'm saying? You had your shootings out here, your killings, your wildness, your buck wild, all this. But out there, it's a different mentality. You know what I'm saying? It's a whole different mentality. And a lot of people, when they first start hearing West Coast groups from out here, they thought, oh, they just exaggerating. It can't be that bad out there. Until you go out there and you see what's going on out there.
Any more times of this humiliation? How many more bouts do we have to lose while we fight for our rights in this nation that we supposed to have since birth? But the breaks and the bricks get worse, so it's jail first. And that's all they offer us. Ain't that right, Mr. Officer?
The chain remains, the chain remains, the chain remains, the chain remains.
Yeah. But you know, it's all founded around here. You know, this like, if you look up there, this William and North 14th. Down there, 15th Street, right, this block here is where Vin grew up.
Seven kids lived in a two-bedroom house, you know? Two-bedroom apartment.
And to those other MCs, naughty by nature, four nigga, please. We just took the time to form three companies. Now the whole industry awaits the new recital. I take your favorite idol. I crumple up the title in the face because I'm fed up with that same old crap. Lack of developing your crew, that's why your stage shows white. So let the sleeping and the swimming. I can't hear myself.
We really started sticking every day, like around the 8th and 9th grade.
Yeah.
So that's when we really just formed up, like back in the New Style days when we first formed the New Style group.
This is
This is New Style.
It's the house where it all started, the headquarters. You might remember this house from Ghetto Bastard, Everything's Gonna Be All Right video. It's KG's home. This the Giz family house. And this is where it all started. We was making noise all up in K room. Miss Giz and Mr. Giz up there just letting us do our thing, feeling our vibes and everything that came up from way back in the days with the New Style era, all that, you know what I'm saying, came from in this house. All the crates of records, the beat machines. We wrote OPP in that house right there. Came up with the whole concept, the idea around it and everything. So this is why we love this and ain't leaving this for nothing. You know what I'm saying? This is the foundation here. This is what started it all. Yeah, still there. I ain't going nowhere. It's all right here. It's all good in the hood. All good in the hood.
Through hip hop, that's really like the only way to let, you know, the rest of the country know what's going on, like over in your own neighborhood or whatever. Or basically, what we talk about on the record is we talk about the, like, around, about our neighborhood. We speaking for the people around there. It's not like we just going on records and cursing or talking this or talking that. It's a message in every record.
Big ol' L-Town finest right there. Police alert. And it's song.
You know, when they say fuck the police, it doesn't mean that they hate the police. It means there's a resentment in the community and that maybe the police themselves.
Yeah, we went to 92 to beat, kicking it, you know what I'm saying, for like 2 hours. I just got off a flight 5 hours from Jersey. Get there, get off, do the interview 2.5 hours, leave,
bro, I'm
you know
sorry,
what I'm saying?
Like,
me
I
and Havoc
like,
just kicking it, you know what I'm saying? Listening to tapes,
weird,
jamming,
or whatever,
cooling.
I'm just looking
in the rearview, pulled over. Like, what's up? They come, get out the car. One, you on the driver. Park, take out the key, get out. This and that and the other. You next. Get out, this and that. Looking at me, where you from? What gang you in? What you doing out this? What is this and that the other? Where you? I'm like, you just come from the radio station. Radio station, what radio station? 92 to beat. People riding by honking. So then that's when they really calm down. Before, we got frisk. You know what I'm saying? My nuts all touched by some nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like that. That shit was, they just played us out. It just fucked up the whole night. You know what I'm saying? Fucked up the whole vibe.
So they made y'all get out the car.
Out the car. Out the car. Interlock your fingers behind your head. You know what I'm saying? People riding by. You just, you know what I'm saying? Just got off the radio station giving advice. I was looking for some advice after that shit.
Even when in Texas, we don't get trooping. That's when I find the baddest bros in Houston boosted. Break down, fill the party.
And then 12 bars after that, let me hear my man. I'm saying, well, you just squeeze it to 12. We'll just do some dissecting.
Number two, clap your hands this evening. It's alright. Clap your hands this evening.
He should be coming in right here. Turn me up a little bit up in my shits. Check it out, I gotta hear myself, I gotta hear myself, I gotta hear myself. I gotta release tension. Come again, I got to mention. Freestyle, free flow, off the dome, once again, you know. Now here we go. Falling through the earth with a burst first for ya. Clapping your hands, now we must say a rah, for sure. But I am still thirsty, oh mercy, it's worthy. Come first, oh curse me, it's Jersey.
If you really want to find out what's going on in the hood, you really want to find out what's going on in the ghettos, all you have to do is tune into hip hop.
Naughty by Nature is nothing without, you know, 18th Street, without East Orange, without Ill Town. Ill Town created us. We are Ill Town. We're just products of Ill Town. And that's basically what we represent.
This is how we do it here. I got barbarians to guard me in the club that part we win. Abroad got thrown like a barn up and thrown again. Thrown abroad, a brim is broke. To the back, I'm bad and brave for brains for broke. The boots were the burnt bear, boots shake the loot.
True.
take this off. You know?
I'm not.
We heard that Mouton is sort of like a movement, and there's like 150 members all together, and you have some sort of new.
I got an answer for that. Wu-Tang Clan rocks the world. Alright, Wu-Tang Clan rocks the world. We gonna have Wu-Tang out here as soon as we us being out here for these little 3 days right here. By the time we leave, we gonna have like 50 Wu-Tang members here. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna keep spreading. I mean, our numbers grow every day.
Yo, this song sounds good too. I might have to go.
Yeah, this one definitely sounds like a great. Yo, man, who's just 16, running up in gates, doing hits for high stakes. You know what I'm saying?
More like to get that money, boy.
Anything, or
anything it takes to eat, anything it takes to live a better life, we deserve to get that money. Anything, positive, negative, we just all about getting there, getting ours.
Y'all doing, yo, man, it's like, man, we live the life, man, there's so much rough shit, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like a nigga grew up in a three-bedroom apartment, right, with like 16 niggas in there, man. You know what I'm saying? Some nights you couldn't have nothing to eat, man. I remember my mom at the time, man, used to put vegetables on a plate with no meat.
That's still something to eat, but I feel it.
Young people, you see a lot of people who have the dread, you know, go to the tanning shop, get, you know, dark skin. That's a part of culture, I think, you know, we try to, you know, catch up with, you know.
Thanks so much, Ghostface.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, you know what I'm saying? I get loves all over the planet, wherever I walks, planet Earth, you know what I'm saying?
I think hip-hop artists is more active, you know. They have more curiosity, they want to go out, you know. But I think that the media has such wrong information, you know, putting a lot of image of the artists. When artists get here, it's just different, you know. They are much more nicer.
It don't really do nothing for your thoughts and shit. But when I smoke some headbanger boogie, some of that fucking Hawaiian shit and all that other good shit, I be writing super crazy ill bongs.
But a lot of brothers in the industry smoke weed. So that's what makes brothers feel like, that's what makes the other motherfuckers feel like, yo, it's something that gotta be together or whatever, man. That's just how we come into this shit, man. We been smoking weed, we gonna keep it like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm on the state, look.
Watch
me.
Trust me.
You got tools right there.
Yeah.
Just on the wall over there, man. You don't want your steak over there.
Check this out.
Wait, two. Y'all know what time it is, right?
Right, these performances seem like a lot of fun to attend. Nobody holding up phones or nothing like that. It's just everybody in there, even if you're playing down or not. But half the time, most of them are in the Boston. My style is awesome. Come on, my family, dude. This is the Boston. And the survey said, you dead. The fatal flag comes in, chops off your fucking head. Yo, bro, this sounds like a good song. Hey, yo, Tuba was back. And the niggas got bone pop.
Cross the clear blue yonder. See, designer CSM tracks like quarterbacks. Tracks of LG. So I try and test. The rebel I get S. Bless. This number, I earn slam the best. Cause I'll bake the cake. Then take the cake and eat it too with my crew. Come on. Yes,
man, I gotta do a lot of this stuff. That sounded like some good stuff.
We got, oh man, brothers is going through the struggle everywhere, man. But where I'm from, Park Hill, I can tell you about Park Hill. Park Hill like this to me, man. You come out on the block, you never know what the fuck's gonna happen. Anything can happen. Like, you could play ball all fucking day, get sweaty and shit. Then later on
man,
that night,
kill that shit, man.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Shit, nobody wanna hear that shit.
Y'all niggas is still worthless, boy. Y'all been fucking playing me for this whole fucking shit just cause the fucking camera's on. Y'all cut that shit out, man.
My mom sending me to school. You know what I'm saying? I never got, couldn't really get fresh and shit. Everybody get fresh for Easter and all that shit. Nigga had like two pair of pants and shit. I gotta wear one pair like two or three times straight or whatever, then change to the next one or whatever and shit.
Yo, I'ma say that shit.
I don't give a fuck. I'll be do that shit any other motherfucking time.
I'm saying like this, y'all brothers.
I don't give a fuck who's around.
Check this out. Whenever it come down this camera shit, y'all niggas get on some bullshit.
Yo, I'ma take it. Like this.
Now I'm taking it back to Arsenio. We is at our fuck that. No. My name was on the paper to say the rhyme or whatever, right? Right? Was it not? Niggas hurt my feelings on some. That nigga, fuck that. How come he always got to do blazy blind this and that? But. Listen, we was in London. My name was on the paper on some Method Man and three other band members do the interviews. Yeah. I ain't hear nobody, why that nigga gotta do all that? No,
fuck
nigga stayed
shit.
In their bags, slept while I went to the radio station by my fucking self. I went up to RCA to Germany by myself.
Fucking right.
You went there three motherfucking other times.
You don't know what you talking about. You don't know what you talking about. Your ass sat in the fucking radio station in the other side on the fucking phone talking to
like
some
this,
hoe
man.
While
let's
we in there doing
fucking
some fucking shit.
I'm trying to get my shit, nigga.
What
fuck
shit?
You talking about? My
what
motherfucking shit? Shirt, nigga, that's still out fucking London. Bitch ass motherfucker.
You trying to get your shirt.
That's
yeah.
Right.
I'm not sure if this is like real, and real
you
real
got
going
paid.
At you or if it's like,
on
right. The phone. So look, I did my interview, nigga. When I was doing the interviews, who was doing all the fucking talking? You was, as usual. You fucking sit up there and talk.
Because look at the asses you give.
This nigga no, too.
Fuck all the cosmetic rap shit.
Y'all niggas want the pain? Yo, motherfuckers want the pain?
Niggas don't want the pain.
Y'all niggas don't want it.
If y'all want the pain, let me hear you say hell yeah.
I got you, baby.
Say hell yeah. Say fuck yeah. Say shit yeah. Just make sure my mic is all the way up. If y'all with me, everybody sing along.
I came to bring the pain, hardcore for the brain.
Let's go inside my ass to play. Find out momentum based on instrumental. Wreck it, hey.
So I can write monumental.
But then I'm not the king. My niggas is deep cash. Stick them on the green.
Check it.
Just stop thinking shit. Get deep into your bed. And brothers and bad things. Accept that.
In your cross color. Comes across over. And I told them he crossed out.
Who the boss?
Nigga get torn to the side.
side of the dark side of the
war.
Of course, it's the method. Man from the Wu-Tang Clan. I'll be hectic. Coming for the head. Leave a jacket. Fuck it. 2 years in a bucket. Think of what the fuck ass. Fuck it. I'm being wrong. Where I'm sick. Sound like fuck round. Bet the bed on some shit. Pull a nigga fast.
I'm sick.
This ain't crazy. Trying to live
crazy.
All the fucking money was a bar.
Is it real, sir?
Is it really real, sir?
Let me know it's real, sir.
If it really real.
Let's take a breath. Bring up that breath.
You better watch that link, nigga.
Yo, get your black ass back up here, man.
Hey, yo, Ron, let's smoke him out, Ron. Smoke him out. Smoke him out.
And you gonna fuck around and get Vic like that.
Word up. Yo, Ron, smoke him out. Yo, Ron. Sure.
Yo, smoke check out. It out. Yo, hundreds of niggas. Yo, hundreds of niggas. Check it out.
Yo, Ron. Major announcement, y'all. Check it out. Next on stage. Live. Coming at your fucking dome.
Word up.
The pioneers of this shit. Y'all niggas show y'all love. But Ron, DMC.
It was dazing, man. That's the word. Dazing. We don't remember like the first few years of our career. It was just big. We were just going.
God's plan.
God's plan. We didn't. We didn't even see it. We was dazing.
Where the SUV and not for sale.
I haven't heard much Run DMC in any.
He's just coming back to Hollis.
The blessing overtook us. We didn't overtake it. It just came and like engulfed us. And Rapperson took us to stardom, and that was it.
I ain't fucking with you. This man D used to come, and they had record ideas and all that, and I just finished school. And I said finished school thinking I ain't gonna fuck with him. Niggas gonna be on. And then people around me start telling me, fuck with your brother, because he's right with his shit, and fuck with DMC, because he's right. And so it came together, and then Jay came along, and they became Run DMC. To us, they like the George Clintons to our parents. And, you know what I'm saying? Like, they, when we were little and not even in the game, in the rap, just more just fans of all the whole thing, they were like the gods of the rap. They, like, took it to that next level that made hip-hop more mainstream and out there. You know what I'm saying? They took it to the level where it could be as commercial as it is today. So if you diss running them, man, you dissing hip-hop.
Names was always L, coming up with names. And then Russell called and said, the name of your group is going to be Run DMC. But see, now, right now, when I'm saying that, it sounds deaf, because Run DMC is the household word. It sounds the whole Run DMC. But imagine that name never existed on the earth. Mm-hmm. And you're standing there, and your manager calls and say, the name of your group is going to be Run DMC.
He knows his name was D to MC, and Run was DJ Run, the son of Curtis Blow. So that's what it was, DJ Run and D to MC, DMC. And that's so, it was easy, Run DMC.
I just seen Joe's face cringe. And then he said, here, take the phone. I'm like, what? He gave me the phone. He said, D, the name of the group is Run DMC. And I still remember that day in Larry Attic. I was standing there, and he said, Run DMC. And it was the worst, stupidest thing I ever heard. And
at that time, it was most important to us to do shit that was very simple and real.
And early in our career, it was always something like that going on. Russell, you're trying to ruin us. They're trying to ruin us. They're trying to ruin us. Even with Rockbox, when he put the guitars on it, oh, they're trying to ruin us.
Our whole thing was, let's try to be real. And the realest thing that you could do was just put a drum beat with nothing but a drum beat. So a record like Suck MC, and also loud, And so we wanted guitars, because we used to always scratch guitars, but not scratch guitar riffs, just the noise. That whole, you cut the beat and you give it dynamics. And that was loud shit.
We was coming up, man. Rap was everything. Rap was, if you go to school, you go to high school, you go to the cafeteria, we beating on the tables, and the kid like runners running his mouth all the time. You go everywhere. Anytime I was a DJ, anytime I bring my turntables out in the park, it'd be 15, at least 10 of them MCs from the neighborhood that were actually almost near fist fight with the mic. It was just like they had to have the mic. It was was like a drug or something.
I love for them niggas, period. That's from being in the game. I mean, I grew up to that shit. When my mom got me a radio for Christmas, she got me a Fat Boys tape and a Run DMC tape. That's all I had.
I'ma slow it down on a real ill B-boy. Catch your heart from back in the day jam and bug your whole life out, make you go home, smack yourself in the back of the head. Put your hands up like this. We gonna go from side to side. Everybody that's with old school hip hop and know about Run DMC from way back in the week. Oh, oh.
I gotta react to some Run DMC.
Old school is groups that made a difference in hip hop pre-recording.
There were a whole slew of groups, underground groups. We call them local bands that were known just around in New York City, like Kool Herc, Bambada, Grandmaster Flash,
Mario.
You can't forget DJ Hollywood,
Mario.
Eddie Cheeba, Love Buck Star.
Right. So check this out. Wait a minute.
Cold Crush.
But the one that you can't forget, DJ Hollywood, and a lot of brothers do forget DJ Hollywood. When you're talking about old school, didn't make a record and making a difference. For me, nobody commanded the crowd better than DJ Hollywood. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and not get on wax.
So that's important. He's the first nigga to say hip hop. And Big Bang Hank was a fake Hollywood, and he know it. And everybody know that everybody who came after Hollywood. When it used to be the House of Joy and Fun Club 371, it was DJ Hollywood with the headliner.
Before we made our first records, we were rapping 5 and 6 years in the clubs, in the block parties, on the streets. You know what I'm saying? Run used to go around to every block party in Queens and rock on the microphone. So he had the experience to handling an audience.
You go to the gym, say Russell Simmons, he'll throw a party, you go there, Grandmaster Flash, Furious Five performing, DJ Hollywood, somebody will sneak a tape in or somebody will get a tape up in the DJ booth and you make the tape, you tape the show, bring it out in the street, sell it $6 to $10. A lot of tapes were sold like that. My first tape I brought was the Cold Crush tape, $6, I paid for it, and it was like an album to me.
Rap has always been here. For many years, when God talked to Moses and any of the prophets, he was rapping with them. If you look at the 30s and the 20s, when Cab Calloway, Hotty Hotty Outta Ho, with the bebop, they was also having their style of rap. If you look at the dozens, when you talk about your mama or your papa, that was dealing with rap.
Who are the real creators of hip hop is a toss up between the bourgeoisie disco hip hoppers and the hardcore B-boy hip hoppers of the Bronx.
This is some trivia for y'all. What MC, made up the terminology, yes, yes, y'all?
Love
Bug. Nope.
Good question. I heard that one before, too.
You tell us, oh, great one.
That right here, there, boy.
Kid Creole.
And Kid Creole.
That's right. He made up the terminology, yes, yes, y'all. He made that up.
Just a bridge from rhyme to rhyme. Once I said a rhyme, in order to get to the next rhyme, yes, yes, y'all.
Every
y'all,
MC that freak, ever y'all. Said a rhyme said, yes, yes, y'all. Your oldest boy money. He wanted money.
Everybody.
All right? You can send me checks. You can send me checks.
The most exciting day of my life, to this day still, there got to be another one coming. It got to be another one coming as big as that because I've been telling this same story forever. Was being at the Garden in 87, and it was sold out, 20,000 people.
They came to the Garden full of confidence with hot records, and they came and did their thing. Remember, Run walking on the stage and talk about, they wouldn't let him in at first. He said, I beg your pardon, but this is my motherfucking Garden.
Yeah, I talked about, okay, I beg your pardon, but this is my effing Garden, and I came out, did my thing. But the ill part about it was, that I told everybody to put their Adidas sneaker in the air.
He pulled up his sneaker, he said, my Adidas.
And it was like 20,000 people took their sneakers off and put it in the air. We was up to like 3 million albums then. I was already excited about that, being up to 3 million albums. And I said, everybody put your sneaker in the air. And everybody had no shoestrings in them, so it was easy to take them off. So they take the sneaker off and they put it in the air. And the guy from Adidas, the representative, when I got off stage, he told me that I was gonna have my own line of Adidas sneakers.
Now check this out. Throw that back over there. We gonna get busy. I'm ready to go to the next level. Y'all ready to go to the next level? We gonna do it like this. D, what's this right here?
Yo, this is my black shirt. You mess around and get hurt.
What's this under there?
Yo, this is my black belt.
I whip MCs and I give them welts.
What's this on your legs?
Yo, these my black pants. I beat you down if I get the chance.
Do me one favor.
What?
What the fuck are these, man?
Huh?
Right there.
Who?
Right there, not Jamel.
What's up, nigga?
Chris.
What's going on? What's up, man?
Jay, he gonna play with us. He's good.
Yeah?
So do y'all got five good players?
Yeah, we got five.
We gonna be real.
Damn, this nigga ain't on my squad?
It's kinda easy when you listen to the G-Dub sound. Pioneer speakers bumping as I smoke on the pound. I got the sound for your ass and it's easy to see that this DJ be more.
When you listen to the G-Dub sound, why would he even say the word easy? You know what I'm saying? When he say easy, you think of easily listening. This music is ill. But what makes it the most interesting to me about the whole thing is he's Dr. Dre's little brother. That takes my mind to a whole nother realm when I think. So Dr. Dre's selling millions and you were supposed to have Snoop, is from what I understand. Snoop was your man, so Dre took him and put him out. And you waited in the boondocks.
You can tell.
And now they gotta give him his.
Summer 92, you know. It was about 20 guys staying at my house at the time. You know, Snoop, Warren, all the guys just that were on the Chronic that were involved in that album. And when I would stop in the studio, they would go down there and start, you know, fucking around with the drum machines and shit. You know, had the shit cranking all night. Learning the shit, you know. I would come in and show them a few things every now and then. But he basically picked it up on his own, you know. And that's like I was telling you, I'd have known the motherfucker was gonna be 2 million copies a couple of years later. I'd have been down there a little bit more, you know.
You could tell that the same person was making
that a funny sound.
Same person was not the only the sound was playing it.
The snare, that the drum machine.
It was the same thing going on, you know what I'm saying? It's just like you and your brother, you know? That's how people were saying it. How are you going to have Russell Simmons managing all these people and Run being down? It's the main rapper.
Hey, I am worried about how Dre is Warren G's older brother, and yeah. I got Russell doing what he do.
There you go.
He had developed his own style. He didn't, you know, didn't use none of the shit that I do, you know, none of my sounds or none of that shit. He just came out and did his own thing, came up with his own shit, which
hey,
is dope.
Hey, Warren G, I see you.
Excuse me!
He came down here last year and I met him last year. Just wanted to see if he still remembered me. Shit. Just I love the beat, the lyrics. I've always listened to it. You know, white people getting into it.
You got some zigzags?
Huh?
You got some zigzags? Oh, did they hear me say that?
Look to the left because dubs some gangsta shit. So I don't give a fuck about these players hating niggas trying to fade us. They can't make us, so we got to take what we want now. Let me take you on a trip up the Jeep, but we bump still got the shit bumping and I twerk. Now recognize game in your face. I touch on the base, I'm a passenger to my niggas. Don't play for a second. Let me wreck shop. It's rainy yet, still dropping rhymes non-stop. But I'm a passenger, trigger flow to my girl named Nev Love. Show them how you do it when you
Yeah, love, high and above all the rest. Watch out because I got stress on my chest. I'm the best at what I do because I rap with the crew. G-Fo. When
it's
I
sign a job,
you don't know me. Even if you do, I'ma break it down because I thought you knew strictly new when I step. Strut, I move my little bun. Brainiac in the house, tip no way.
A WAP and a what's the biggest nuggets you got?
9
pieces.
Burger King.
2 large fries.
A fat apple pie.
I wish we could. A lemon pie.
A medium Coke. Some fries.
Ain't got no hash browns, dude.
Oh yeah.
Some onion rings.
A apple pie.
And a WAP.
Oh man, and a whopper with cheese.
It's down there though. It's gonna stay down there because I ain't taking out no more of my stuff.
Ooh, I'm fixing bread.
I see.
I do want vegetables, but I'm subject to Burger King every day of my life. But I have to make this work because I am a phenomenal woman. Maya Angelou.
Day two.
Yeah. 180.
Too many.
I'm Burger King.
Hey, bro, where are you going? You forgot your application.
Oh, man. I got a real job.
If you ain't in the house, you was in the shack. Fire up the sack. MG Grace hits. Liat.
Stand back, give me some room, because when this is over,
seven dice.
I'm going to need a broom.
A boy, you don't need a broom.
Gotta keep the bus clean. We ain't had no dirty bus. I always do this. See, most niggas don't clean that bus up. I clean my shit up. I hate a dirty bus.
3 times in a row. He passed 3 times in a row. And then I bet with it.
Before it's Russell come from me, I look at Russell as whoever want to deny it, don't want to give him his props, they got to give it to him. Russell Simmons made the way for, if it's Suge, if it's Dre, if it's anybody in the hip-hop business, because he started it.
What's LL Cool J?
LL Cool J,
listen, John.
I need a beat. Around the way, girl, I'm
going to
back
here
in my Jeep. I'm
bad.
Radio.
What the fuck? Is somebody high? That's fucking wrong. Where's,
face.
That list is crazy. What? I want to kill Kathy.
In 1984, I had sent a tape into this guy named Rick Rubin. He was the guy who gave me my break. Everybody knows him. And he introduced me to Russell at Russell's office. He had a small office down on Broadway.
Too much of any
me and Rick
either.
Played a record for him called I Need a Beat. And he really liked that record. So what happened was instead of them taking that record and going to a distributor and trying to get it distributed and having problems with the money, they decided to form an independent company called Def Jam and put that record out.
Because I know he'd be dropping a lot of knowledge to his artists, you know what I'm saying? Because he got a lot of artists. And Russell definitely knows how to make money. That's all I want to do is sit down and let's ask him questions about how I can make money. Let me know everything I could do to make a million, Russ, because I know you know what to do.
How much is payroll? How much is all that shit equal up? Look, that's your problem, right? I mean, that's my problem, but you're working on it.
It started out with, you know, tall, skinny bitches, like I was in high school. Looking at magazines and saying, that she's fine, I want to meet this hoe. Then the next thing I know, I've been hanging out at all the parties where you get one party and it'd be 60 girls, they all be 6 feet and fine. So that's, you know, and I guess no niggas could be mad at going there. Then after that, I met the clients and all the people who run all the department stores and buy all the clothes. And then I started looking at the fabrics and the clothes, the way they were making them, and I started, you know, seeing how niggas, you know, hip-hop niggas influence all the shit that they try to do anyway. You know, I'd see Chanel, I'd go to the Chanel show, and Karl Lagerfeld got a big gold chain around a bitch neck. I was like, how fake is that, you know? Fat Farm became like a hobby, you know, and I started making clothes. And I looked at the fabrics that, and started to really understand the business through all the designers and the editors and the models. I started really, it became a real serious hobby. And that hobby became more serious as we put more money into it. Let me tell you something, when I first started hanging out with these tall girls, they wasn't playing hip-hop music in the parties. I used to feel like, you know what I'm saying, I had to have a reason to be up in that spot besides for some tall bitch. Because my job is to get money. And I didn't mean bitch like, I mean worldly, sophisticated,
yeah,
independent,
sure
badass bitch, you know. The kind of hoes every man want to marry.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I didn't want to say it like, bitch, you know, because I know people will be watching this who ain't hip-hop and might not understand when I say bitch, I mean bad bitch. You know, super bitch, you know, super powerful, independent, successful bitch.
Right.
Not like no necessarily, not at all derogatory. In no
okay,
way,
yeah,
you know
we get it.
I love women. I can't sympathize with all the rappers be talking. They hate them hoes, all that. I love girls.
Thank you, Daddy.
Hello.
Hey, who got some gangsta shit?
Niggas.
You got some gangsta shit.
Fuck that shit.
Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta shit.
Sing it. Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta
shit. Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta shit.
And that's why right now none of them brothers could go on tour, where everybody here went on big tours, you know,
and no
and 30 cities tours. They can't go on tour because don't nobody want the rap in the building.
You don't know what it's like to go platinum and sit home.
You have new guys who come out, they go platinum. They've never seen 20,000 people or 10,000 people or 1,000 people or 100 people.
The difference between what we did and what they doing now, it was a form of entertainment. When you came into concert and you seen, like if you see a Run DMC show, or you see a Houdini show, or you see a Curtis Blow show, you seeing a show. You see a Grandmaster Flash show, you seeing a show, you see these boys right now, you see just a brother out on stage. And that ain't pulling no weight.
Back in the day, in 1976, when I started rapping, I was in a group called Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And even though like things were rugged and things were tough, we felt like there was an opportunity for us to be successful. So people would make raps that are different from today. Like people would make raps, like I made a record called Getting Money. Everything's funny when you get money. Because I felt like there was an opportunity to get money. Now rappers are making smash hits like Bring the Pain. Because people feel like they're growing up in a time where there's no system for them to figure out how to get money. So I think that I was born in 1960, so I might have been the last generation of the affirmative action rap group. And now you got Reaganomic rap groups. And Reaganomics took away after school programs, took away summer jobs, took away student loans. So you got a whole generation of rappers who are growing up under the auspices of Generation X, who grew up with no hope, and all they see is pain.
Living up to what you see on records, it's all entertainment. Anybody in their fucking right mind know you can talk about shooting somebody on the record, but motherfucker ain't finna really go out there and do it unless you just stupid. You know what I'm saying? It's entertainment, you know? We make records, it's entertainment. That's all it is. This is like our fucking jobs, you know?
There'd be always one motherfucker that'll do some shit, like throw some shit on stage. I remember, man, this nigga threw some shit on stage, man. And you know, we roll with the fort. Niggas just like zoomed in. Right off the stage, niggas just whipped his ass right the fuck out the arena, came back on, we just finished the show and shit. Like, it used to pop off like that often and be like, nigga, fuck them niggas. And then you turn around like, what, they all...
Yeah, like that.
And then we be like, who said that shit? Then the whole crowd be like, him, him.
Yo, we gotta line these niggas up, son.
Line these niggas up.
Yo, what the fuck? They ain't lining them fucked up. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What the fuck up? What's up?
Come on.
What the fuck? What the fuck? Close your doors. Big and small. Check in the line at my crib. Turn this up in, he had to do a bit. I'm on the 3, here, on the 93. I'm ready to get this paper, G. Believe me,
motherfucking right. I have my pockets looking kinda tight.
Yeah, yeah.
Stress, yo, Biggie, let me get the vest.
No need for that, just grab the fucking
jack.
Yeah. The pocket that's fat, take us to his back.
On his bar, I was hungry.
Let him fake no move. Treat him like boxes, stick and move, stick and move.
Besides selling the records, you know, artists get their money from their shows. You got a tight-ass show. Niggas don't want to see you, so me and Puff just tried to make the tightest show we could for me.
He makes Biggie Smalls and Craig Mack Flavor in Your Ear. All those records are his. I had to call him my protege, but he's selling more records than me right now, so I got a new name for the nigga now.
Bad Boy Entertainment, you know what I'm saying? We done did Mary J. Blige, Jodeci when I was at Uptown, Fallen C, Heavy D. Now we got Notorious Big, Craig Mack, a lot of new acts coming out, still on TLC, Pebble. Trying to make some noise, it's a young black company. Bad Boys for Life, you know what I'm saying?
Anything we could do to get the crowd crazy, anything we could do, we'd just do it. It wasn't such a big nigga, I'd have been jumping in the crowd too. But I ain't really with that extracurricular shit.
I've listened to Juicy. I was a part of Juicy. And Big Papa. Big Papa I like. Big Papa I like.
The car is out.
Yeah.
Put your motherfucking hands up.
Yeah.
Sweat style and grace, allow me to lay me lyrical dishes in your bushes. Who rock grooves and make moves with all the mommies?
The back of the club,
sipping my wet is where you find me.
The back of the club,
knocking holes, my crew behind me. Mad question asking, blood passing, music blasting.
Yeah,
I just can't quit because one of these honeys, Biggie,
got to creep with.
Sleep with, keep the apple secret. Why not?
Why not?
Why blow up my spot? Cause we both got cock.
Now check it.
I got more Mac than drinking in the bed. Believe me, sweetie, got enough to feed the needy. No need to be greedy. Got mad friends
and bitches.
See those by the layers. True fucking players. Jump in the rover and come over. Tell your friends you're in the GS3. Smoking chronic by the tree car.
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
Throw your hands in the air if you're a true player.
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
Shut the honeys getting money playing niggas like dummies.
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
You got my gun up in your waist. Please don't shoot up the place.
Why?
Cause I see some ladies tonight that should be having
what? Okay.
What? Straight up, honey, really, I'm asking. Most of these niggas think they be macking, they be acting. Who they attracting with that line?
What's your name? What's your sign?
Soon as he buy that wine,
I just creep up from behind.
They ask you what your interests are.
Who you be with?
Things to make you smile. What numbers to dial? You gon' be here for a while. I'ma call my crew.
You gon' call your crew.
We can rendezvous at the bar round two. Plans to leave, throw the keys a little steam. Pull a truck up front, roll up the next blunt. So we can steam all the way to the telly. Go fill my belly.
Yeah.
T-bone steak, cheese eggs, and munchies.
That's right.
Conversate for a few views. In a few, we gon' do what we can and do. Ain't that right, boo?
To me, this is what hip-hop means.
He killed that.
To write a rhyme
to just create, to have a microphone in your hand, and people...
Let me see what that is real quick. Alright, let's go ahead and keep this thing going.
In front of you, and for them to know that what you're saying is butter. To me, hip-hop is a way of life. You know what I'm saying? It's what you wake up in the morning, and it's who you are, and it's representing what I am and what I feel inside.
Shit, hip-hop to me is way out. You know what I'm saying? It's like, just imagine. Just look at all the fucking rappers out there, all the motherfuckers that's doing hip-hop music, and ask them what would they be doing if hip-hop never came around. You have a lot of dead motherfuckers. You have a lot of broke motherfuckers out there. Because there's a lot of motherfuckers out there trying to get into hip-hop or already in hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? So it's a way out. It's fucking opportunity. You know what I'm saying? It's fucking big business.
The things nowadays that make me happiest, besides for the things I can buy, and the other shit that comes along with people's conventional idea of what will make them happy. If I get a little paper and I could hire a nigga straight out of jail whom I grew up with, which we do all the time, friends, we help, you know, and they become successful and they get their shit on, and I see that, or if I find an artist who just came out and the nigga's really hard working, really has a vision and believes in himself and is trying and trying, and suddenly I give this man a contract and he blows up, he's on the cover of Rolling Stone, and he gonna have little rich black babies, then that kind of thing means a lot to me now more than, you know, wow. And I didn't realize how much I appreciate seeing those things happen.
You in this shit now? The motherfuckers is telling you be here and there and that and there. You gotta establish a type of relationship with them where you know that they work for you. You don't work for them. You know what I'm saying? Everything that you do is for you. So every move that you make, make sure it's all out, because it's gonna matter in the end and shit.
But right now, rap is in its proper position, and it's open doors. It opened doors for Run DMC, and Run DMC opened doors for people, and now the people that followed after Run DMC are still opening doors.
Hip hop is young pop culture. Like young pop culture with rock, like pop culture with jazz, with blues. Young pop culture then was young black culture too. But the difference in hip hop is that young niggas is on the screen selling hip hop.
The reason why we make these records, we're crying out about our environment, we're crying out about our system. So now that, you know, you can appeal to 1.5 million, 2 million, 3 million people, telling them about your environment, after a point, it's not like you just take the benefits of it and just chill and live in a fat house or have fat cars and have all the women and never mind the rest of your environment. It's up to you, you know, your environment made you. Now it's up to you to give back to the community.
Rap has become and a device of expression now, more or less. When we did it, we came out, it was just fun. You know, to this day, if we wasn't making records, we'd still have to get together and go in Hollis Park and throw a party. You know, I'd still be writing rhymes. If I was working at the post office, I'd have a book of rhymes. And today, rappers are just talking about what they're allowed to talk about, to express themselves musically.
You know what? There's one thing right now I want to say again. There's one thing I find amazing. That I've been here since 1982. I think before some little girl over there was even born. And they still called me out to do this movie and to go on last after the likes of Wu-Tang and Biggie Smalls and Craig Mack. And these kids were kids when I was doing this. And I'm just thankful, right, that I can still be able to come out here 12 years later and be able to do this and get support from people like y'all. So I want to ask y'all one question. I want everybody to get silent for me 1 minute in here. Everybody just shut up for a second.
Wow.
How many people out there down with the old school know about Run DMC? Put a hand in the air. If you're from the old school and you know from your heart and you seen Run DMC get busy before, put a hand in the air like this for all the old school from way, way back. And know about that. That's where all this new school come from, the old school. Now check this out. For all the true hip-hop fans out there, I'ma do a little something like this. This is my nigga right here. He go by the name of DMC. That's your Mr. J. We gonna do it like this. Now DJ Rock!
Yeah, you gotta let them know. You gotta let them know.
You don't think they know?
I don't think they know, Cho.
I gotta take them back then. College crew style for sure. This is real. If it's ever been real, these turntables is on. Ain't no dat. Use a dat, you get this. It's either this or that. We're gonna do it like this. 1, 2, 1, 2. Now DJ Run. My name, Jam Master J, is his. He's the MC.
It's like that.
And that's the way it is.
I got a record.
You know what I'm saying? Love, whatever. You know what I'm saying? You can see a problem. You can hate your enemy, but that don't mean you got to, you know what I'm saying, go at him with a gun and all that. You just got to know how to give him the water to change his way of life or whatever the case. You know? So your benefit and growth. So it's all about the whole world coming together. That's maybe why rap is like that. Rap is not singing and all that. Rap is just straight out talking. And maybe that's why it's like that. Maybe that was what God wanted to happen. Maybe he just wants the whole world to hear somebody say, y'all, what's going on? Straighten up.
Yo, what's up?
Yo.
You ready, son?
Clock hit one time. Say what?
When I met you, I admit my first thought was a trick.
Hands in the air.
You look so good. I suck on your daddy's dick. I never felt that way in my life.
Right.
It didn't take long before I made you my wife.
That was interesting.
Just my main squeeze.
Not even up front. The first like 20-30 minutes of it was like way better, I feel like. As it went on, it kind of got not as, you know what I'm saying, good as I was going to expect it to be, but it was very interesting learning about like the different experiences all these groups and artists have had. But I just wish it was more, I don't know, it just didn't feel like it was a lot to it. It was like somebody talk for a second, then we go to this live performance. Then somebody talk for a second, then we go back to the live performance. Then somebody talk for a minute or however long, then we go back. Like, it was just a constant back and forth, which was, I wasn't really against it, but it wasn't all that. You know what I'm saying? It could have been better, but it was definitely, definitely a great little documentary. And the strange thing is that, like, it didn't even really feel like a documentary. It felt like just like a journey throughout all of their, like, careers and stuff. But definitely worth the watch. And if you guys enjoyed my reaction, which if you did, honestly, I'm not sure how, because literally I just sat here with a blank stare on my face like the whole time just watching it. But that's only because like you can't do nothing but just sit here. You know what I'm saying? I try not to do as much commentary, especially when I'm soaking in a lot of stuff like they were spitting in this little video. But if you guys enjoy the reaction, smack the like button as usual. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Much love and peace out.